The destroy function can be used to remove game objects or components from game objects at runtime. This can also be done with a timed delay by using its second argument, a float number. To destroy a game object, for example, we could simply refer to the game object the script is attached to. In this example, when the spacebar is pressed, the game object will be destroyed. Now, a problem could be that you may be using this script for various purposes, so it doesn't make sense to destroy the object, as the script component will be removed too, as it's attached to the object. So instead, you'd likely use a reference to another object. Here, we've set up a public variable called other to refer to another object. Then, in the inspector, we'll drag on another object to use, for example, our physics door. Now, when we press play and press space, our door gets removed from the scene. You can also use the destroy command to remove components, rather than entire game objects. For this, we use the getComponent function inside the destroy parentheses to refer to a component. In this example, I'll destroy the mesh renderer component so that the object is no longer visibly rendered. Here you can see that the object is still in the game and has all of its other components except for the mesh renderer that we removed. All of these examples can include a number as the second argument in order to create a time delay. For example, if I add 3 as a floating point number as my second argument, save the script. Once I've pressed the spacebar, there will be a 3-second delay, and then my object will be removed. This works the same for destroying components.